As promised, part two, Bob Vail with Frank Layden at the Gallagher Center.
Speaking about your time in the pros, you coached a couple, or you drafted and coached a couple NBA legends with John Stockton and Karl Malone.
I never heard of them. I swear, I never heard of them. I mean that. John Stockton came from a little school, Gonzaga, and, we couldn't even get, they didn't even film their game, so I didn't know who he was. You know, I had the all-star point guard and Ricky Green on my team, so we took him really because we heard Portland, who was drafting after us, was real interested in him, and we thought we'd draft him and maybe trade him to them. And so I hadn't heard. Karl Malone came from Louisiana Tech. And when I saw movies of him play, I said, he won't be around when the time comes for us to pick. Well, sure enough, we were bearing down with like two picks to go, and there's Karl Malone still sitting there. I said to myself, why is he there? There must be something wrong with him, and we don't know about it, you know? So we drafted the two of them, really virtually from my standpoint, with trust in our system, in our assistant coaches, particularly Scott Layden, my son, who was one of my assistant coaches. He said, Coach, we got to take Stockton. We can trade him later on. We got to take Malone. If he can't do it, we'll trade him. But he is a bruiser and a brute. Now, together, and I told this to the team today, together they made a Hall of Fame pair, all right? I really believe that if Karl Malone had played on any other team and without John Stockton, he never would have made the Hall of Fame. He's second in all-time scoring to Jabbar, and I really think that John would have never been the great player he was. Don't forget that these two guys also were on the Dream Team, two Dream Teams. Yep. And the thing is with them is that when they were together, they were dynamite. I don't think separately they would have been quite the players that they were then.
Staying with your time with the Jazz, 1984 was a pretty good year for you. You won Coach of the Year, Executive of the Year, and the
You have to be honest, that was a bad year, you know, for everybody else. It was a very good year for me. You know, I look around and you got to get lucky. You know, we were so bad that we only won 44 games that year, all right? But people thought that that was a miracle. That's how bad we were, you know? And so I was the general manager, and, you know, I always say this. When you have success, you got to be careful. We get too much credit. And when you fail, you get too much blame. And so, you know, it was one of those years, but it felt good. You know, I got the awards, the ones about citizenship and what have you. My wife, Barbara, has much to do with that. She took care of all the committees and raising money and everything, so she should have got that award. But, you know, I was the only one to get it, and I remember Jerry West calling me up and saying, you know, it's so unique. He said, it's hard to believe, but no matter what else, whatever challenges you meet in your life, you will never be able to repeat the winning the trifecta like that. And don't forget, I was a Niagara man. Another thing is, when I was in the NBA, we had three Niagara players as head coaches at the same time. Great trivia question.
Yep.
Larry Costello, Hubie Brown, the great Frank Layden. Imagine, huh? Three Niagara players from this little school were head coaches in the NBA.
Bringing things full circle, speaking of Niagara, all these years later, they bring you back. They're retiring your jersey. They're raising your banner to the rafters. What does it mean to you that this school is still honoring all that you did and then how you represented it as you went forward?
Well, you know what? A lot of things have happened since I left here. They gave me an honorary degree a few years ago. Of course, I'm in the Hall of Fame. You know, it's about people. It's about relationships. A lot of my best friends are guys I graduated with or alumni that I met later on when I was coaching Niagara. Niagara was home for me. You know, let me put it this way. I never had a mother. My mom died in childbirth, my childbirth. So I never had a mother. And someone, my dad, said to me, Niagara is your mother. Niagara is your alma mater. It's your mother. And that's the truth. And so, you know, when I look at those names, and I did this afternoon when I was watching practice, when I see the names up there, Birch, Sinicola, I mean, you know, I look up and I say, wow, do I belong up there? I personally don't think so. But, you know, I can't criticize these people. It sounds like they probably made a very wise decision.
Oh, I think you absolutely deserve to be up there. And lastly, you're a very quotable guy. We still have some Ladenisms, if you will, that float around the office. One of my personal favorites is, you know, you try at it as best you can, but if all else fails, you can always blame assistant coaches.
Yes, that's right. And there's always things you could do, you know. I remember I had a player one time, and this is a true story. And, you know, I said to him in sincerity, I said, what's wrong with you? You're inconsistent. I mean, I said, one day you get 10 points and two rebounds. The next day you get 10 rebounds and 2 points. What is it, ignorance or apathy? He said, Coach, I don't know and I don't care.
That's perfect. I think that's a great place to end here at the Gallagher Center today. Frank, thank you so much for talking to us today.
Thank you very much, Bob. It's been a pleasure.
That'll do it for us here
at
the Gallagher.
It's been a semi-pleasure.
That'll do it for us here at the Gallagher Center. Jeremy, back to you.
Deservedly so. Frank Layden in the rafters. We thank Bob Vail.